Hi, I'm Anna Thomas, a data and applied scientist on the Azure SQL team. In this episode of Data Exposed, I'm joined by Mark Russinovich, our CTO of Azure, and we're going to talk a little bit about the future. Thanks for joining us, Mark.
Thanks, Anna.
So the first question I have for you is kind of an easy question. Mm-hmm. I'm on the SQL team. This is a data show. Can you tell us a little bit about your history of data?
Well, so data is actually a key part of the cloud platform. I've been in Azure since 2010, and already by the time I'd started, Azure SQL Database was right. One of the first PaaS services that came up on the platform. So it's been part of the Azure journey.
You've talked a little bit about your history. Can you tell us about where we're going? Like, where do you see the Azure platform or data specifically headed over the next few years?
So I think there's a couple trends you're starting to see. One of them is multimodal infrastructure, right. Data infrastructure, Cosmos DB being a really great example of that, with five or six APIs and counting right. on top of the same core, which provides all of those different APIs, these awesome consistent capabilities like geo-replication and multi-master and different consistency levels. So I think you're going to see more of that. I think also bringing compute to the data is something else that you're also seeing. Again, Cosmos DB with
the introduction of Spark.
You see this in our storage service too. There's going to be compute coming to that as well. And even Azure Storage has multimodal on top of that. So those two plus those kind of capabilities that Cosmos DB has really pioneered, like global replication, is kind of, I think, the trends that you're seeing in data.
And as far as the database landscape goes, what do you think is the next big thing?
I mean, there's a few next big things. I think more near term, I think next big things are basically having this consistent capabilities across all these different data services, trying to, while you've got this concept of data lake, you still see these data islands end up in these particular data stores. You're going to see bringing the analytics capabilities on top of a data lake where you can ingest and process data from diverse sources. I think that's a big thing that's happening right now. Another one, I think that you've mentioned before me getting into is blockchain. Right. If you take a look at what a blockchain is, it's a database. It's a distributed shared database that's decentralized, but at its core, it's a database. It's keeping track of transactions. Mm-hmm. And there's, if you take a look at all of the existing blockchains, they're all brand new database implementations that don't have the kinds of ecosystems that ones that are more mature like SQL have. And it'd be interesting to look at what kind of blockchain capabilities or verifiable logs kind of capability that is one aspect of blockchain could we bring to an existing mature database.
So as you kind of talk about these databases and new databases and these specialized use cases, do you see in time that we'll continue to diversify the different types of databases in the landscape? Or do you think we'll start to simplify and converge to one sort of database?
Yeah, it's a really good question. I think there's always this underlying kind of trend or effort to say, we can put all of the databases on top of converge on one to rule mm-hmm. them all. But I think that the reality is a little more complex. There's different workloads that have different data access patterns that need to be optimized. And there's different APIs that are better suited for different kinds of applications and the way that they store data. So if you take a look at NoSQL and SQL, the NoSQL emerged because SQL just wasn't great at handling the kinds of data access patterns and storage that NoSQL was great at. And you don't see a convergence of those two technologies and saying NoSQL and SQL are on top of even the same infrastructure,
right.
much less having the same APIs. So there's going to be different cases, and they're likely going to be more rather than more convergence. Even in the case of Azure SQL, there's different services that are optimized for different workloads. Azure SQL Database and Azure SQL, two different workloads, same API, underlying different infrastructure optimized for each case. So bottom line is I don't believe that there's going to be a big convergence. I think, if anything, we might see
more
specialization.
Mm. Well, very interesting. Yeah. Thanks, Mark. Thanks for sharing.
Thanks.
And thanks for joining us today on our show. Thank you all for tuning in to this episode of Data Exposed. Be sure to tune in next time where we ask Mark about SQL specifically. In the meantime, feel free to like this video, comment on what you'd like to see more of, and subscribe to our channel. Until next time, thank you.